Hello all, welcome to part 52 of Python tutorial. In this session, I'm going to explain and practically demonstrate super in Python. So let's get started. Super in Python can be used for accessing the parent class properties from a child class when the parent class properties have the same name as a child class properties. This is one requirement of using the super in Python. What about the second requirement? Super in Python can also be used for calling the parent class init function from the child class init function. That's the second requirement. These two requirements I'm going to practically demonstrate now. For that, I'll open this PyCharm ID where we have the sample Python file. Inside the sample Python file, I'll first create a parent and child classes. So class A, and here under this class A, I'll create some sample properties. Say A is equal to 5. And also I'll create a sample function. Okay, I'll just name that as sample only. Sample. And here I'll say print if this particular method inside this class A is called, I'll print inside sample method of class A. I'll print this statement, okay, when you call this method of this class. Now, I'll create another class, say class B, okay? I'll create another class, class B, and I will make this class B a child class of the class A, like this. Here, B is a child class of the class A. And under this also, I'll create the same properties, okay? Properties having the same name, I'll create under the child class. Here also, I'll say A is equal to, but I'll give a different value just to differentiate. Here, the name of the variable is same, right? In the parent class, same A is there. In the child class also, same name A is there. Okay. Now, df, again, sample. Okay. Df sample. This is same. Method name is also same inside the child class. Now, here I'll, if this particular method in the child class is called, I'll print out saying inside sample method of class B, like this. Okay. Now, I'll create one more method. Let's say def. Print properties. I'll just give it some random name saying print properties like this. Okay. Now here I will print the value of the variable A. Okay. So I'll say self.a. Okay. So the value, okay, the value that is stored in the variable A of this class B need to be printed, right? Here again, I'll say self dot sample. Now, if I create an object for the class B like this, outside the class, when I create an object for the class B and assign that object to the OBJ kind of object reference, here name of the object reference is OBJ. Using that object reference, if I call this print properties, what values will be printed? Okay, what will happen, guys? When you call this print properties using the object reference of the class B, what will happen? This method inside the class B will be called. And here print self.a means, does it print the inherited value from the parent class A, or it will print the value that is stored into the variable A in the child class itself, either 5 or 10. Inherited value or inherited property or the class own property. Here self.a means it will only, okay, it will actually print the value of this class own property variable. Okay. So here even self.sample means this sample method which is there in the child class will be called rather than calling the same sample method in the parent class. Okay. When you are saying self means the class related properties, okay, the child class related properties, that is a is equal to 10 and sample method inside sample method of class B will be called. Run this code, you will see that 10 and inside sample method of class B are getting printed, right? But what I want is, I want to retrieve these values, okay? I want to print the value of A, which is there in the parent class. And also, when I call this method, guys, okay? When I call this method, the value of A, which is 5, should be printed. And this sample method, which is there in the parent class, should be printed, okay? Should be called. And this statement inside that method should be printed. So here, what I have to do in that case is, to make that possible, I have to use, instead of using self.a, I will use super.a. The moment I use super.a, it will get this variable a from the parent class. Okay, it will not prefer this child class variable, rather it will get the variable having the same name in the parent class, because I'm saying super means parent, right? Parent variable A. Here also, instead of saying self.sample, if I say super.sample, it will get the, we call the sample method in the parent class rather than calling the sample method in the child class. Okay, now run this code. This time you'll get 5 and inside sample method of class A will be printed. 5 and inside sample method of class A will be printed. Okay, this is one of the use of super in Python. Okay, as I mentioned, super in Python can be used for accessing the parent class properties from a child class which are having the same name as the child class properties. Okay, when parent class properties have the same name as the child class, from the child class, if you want to access the parent class properties, then you have to use super. That's one requirement, one thing that you can use super for. The second thing is for calling the parent, okay, for calling the init function or init method inside the parent class, you have to use super. So for that, let me demonstrate, guys. Again, I'll clear all this stuff. Freshly, I'll create class A. Okay. Freshly, I'll create class A. Inside this class A, I'll create an init method. Def underscore underscore init underscore underscore self. Okay. So here, if this particular init method, okay, of the class A is called, okay, when you create object for the class, automatically init method of the class will be called, right? So whatever it is, when this particular init method is called inside this class, it will print inside init method of class A. Okay, this is what I will print. Now I'll create one more class. I'll call that as class B. I'll make this class B a child class of the class A. Okay, and here I'll not create anything, guys. I'll simply write pass statement here. Okay, so if I don't have to implement this class, instead of not providing any of the statements, I'll simply provide the pass statement, which is nothing but nothing will happen, guys. If the class B is called or something will happen, nothing will happen here. Pass doesn't any, instead of keeping it empty, I'm just providing pass, that's it. Okay, now in this case, guys, if I create an object for the class B like this, okay, and assign that object to the object reference obj, so generally init will be called, okay, init function or init method will be called when you create an object. But here I am creating the object for which class, A or B? I am creating the object for the class B, which is a child class of the class A. Okay, I'm creating an object for the class B, which is a child class of the class A. So what happens here is, since class B doesn't have any init method, you see, class B doesn't have any init method. In that case, since the parent class A has a init method, okay, even though I create an object for the child class, okay, the init method from the parent class will be called, guys. Okay, so if there is no init method inside the child class, automatically the init method inside the parent class will be called. Okay, when you create an object for the child class, this is going to happen. Now run this code. When I run this code, guys, simply by creating an object, okay, don't have to create object reference also, just by creating an object for the child class, automatically, okay, if there is an init method inside the class B, the init method inside the class B would have been called automatically when I create an object. But here, class B, which is a child class, doesn't have the init method. So in that case, it will check whether the parent class has any init method or not. If it is there, it will invoke the init method in the parent class. That's going to happen now, guys. Run this code. You see, inside init method of class A is being printed. That means this particular method got invoked. When I create an object for the child class, init method inside the parent class got invoked. That's good. Okay, now instead of this pass statement, I'll create init method here also. I'll say init underscore underscore. So now child class has its own init method. Now if I say print inside init method of class B, I'll say, okay, inside init method of class B. What's the problem here? Nothing. Let's see, if I create an object for the child class, run this code, what's happening, guys? Now since the class B has its own init method, okay, instead of invoking the init method of the parent class, okay, the child class init methods has been invoked. You see, inside init method of class B this time. Earlier we got class A, because at that time init method was not there inside the class B. Then parent class init method was invoked. Now, since the child class has its own init method, okay, when you create an object for the child class, automatically it will prefer the child class init method. Okay, it will call the, it will invoke the child class init method. But my requirement is, okay, even though this particular method is invoked, from this init method, I want to call this init method. Okay, still I want to call the parent class init method from the child class init method. Further, guys, what I will do here is I will add something like this. Okay, here I will add super. So from the child class init method, I am going to call the parent class init method. Further, super dot, I have to say init. That's it, guys. Nothing much. Okay, super dot init. What happens here is when you create an object for the child class, this child class init method will be invoked if it has, and when it calls this init method of the child class, the first statement here is it will call the parent class init method from the child class init method because using the super, guys. Okay, this will be called. That means first inside init method of class A will be printed. After that, inside init method of class B will be printed. Run this code. You see, first init inside init method of class A, because this super was invoking the super inside the child class init method is invoking the init method of the parent class. Okay, after that, the remaining statement inside init method of the class B is getting printed. So this is how, guys, we can use super in Python. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.